Welcome back, friends. See, this is the playlist for Spring Boot microservices testing framework and Docker. I am planning to cover all the topics part of this playlist. Already Spring Boot is covered and microservice started one session. The 13th session is fourth session of microservices. In this session, I covered introduction of microservices and how to implement config service and Eureka naming service. So all these videos are real classes. While taking classes for students, I recorded this video. All videos are more than 1 hour or more than 1 hour duration. Okay. From now on, I'll going to record the video for continuing the rest of microservice and Docker framework, testing framework session. All those video will be maximum 20 minutes. I don't want to record a 1 hour lengthy video. Okay. When I teach microservices, I was using 2.3.2, I think. The version is 2.2.3, I think. Let me confirm that. Where is that? Let me confirm that. Yeah, I used 2.4.2. Now, when I look at this Spring initializer, they're saying they're having a 2.4.5 now. They updated. Okay, now from now on, I'm going to use 2.4.5. There is no any technical changes. Just to follow whatever explained in this video. Whatever explained is for just to follow that. Even 2.4.5 version also, it will work as it is. Okay. This is our microservice architecture. When you see this, if you watch this video, right? If you watch this video already, you understand that I'm planning to cover this architecture, a part of microservice cloud. Okay. As of now, I completed config server service registry. I implemented the config server service registry. Those coding part I have added part of this video. Part of this video, the video description, you can take it. Now we need to implement account service. We need to implement all the component. Now I'm planning to implement account service. Then I want to enable this account service part of microservice cloud environment. Okay. This account service is a simple Spring Boot application. Okay. Now we want to make this Spring Boot application part of our microservice cloud component. That meaning you should be able to communicate API gateway. They should be able to communicate config server. They should be able to communicate service registry. Okay, we have to implement this. Once implemented this, that we can consider that account service part of this microservice cloud component. Okay, first we need to create an account service Spring Boot application. Then we need to add some artifact. For example, if you want to communicate config server from the account service, we need to add one artifact. That is config client artifact we need to add. Through that artifact, it will provide some library. Using that library, account service able to communicate config server. What is the purpose of config server? Config servers holds all the microservice configuration files. Config servers holds microservice configuration files. That is config server connecting with one Git repository. Config server connecting with one Git repository. In that Git repository, we are maintaining all microservice configuration. For example, let me show that. This is my Git repository. In this Git repository, see here, I have one repository called config. In this config, I have a lot of YAML files. Let's say account service. We'll take example of account service. You can see account service hyphen dev, account service hyphen QA, account service hyphen YAML. So three different account service configuration file we have. One for dev environment, one for QA environment, one for default environment. I'll going to use account service hyphen YAML file in our example. Okay. So all the configuration we're maintaining in the Git repository. We are maintaining in the Git repository. We need to connect the Git repository, load the configuration file, overload the configuration file. That particular task done by our config server. Now config server loading the on the configuration, keep it in the config server. Then that config server should distribute to the appropriate microservice. For example, account service need account service configuration. So account server should connect config server. Connect server, config server return the configuration of account service. Okay, configuration account service. That particular activity we can implement by adding one artifact. I will tell that. Then we need to register this account service inside a Eureka naming server. So that meaning it's a part of our Microsoft cloud component. Okay. These two tasks we need to do. Okay. We'll going to implement later API gateway. Okay. Then we need to create a one Spring Boot application. We need to configure database. Then we need to connect with config server. We need to connect with service registry. This particular task we'll going to implement now. Okay. Open Spring Initializer. See, this is Spring Initializer. We are using latest version of 2.4.5. 1 minute. I want to show one thing. So the Spring Cloud, there is a Spring Cloud service for directory, right? Here, all services implemented using 2.4.2. Now I'll going to use a latest version of my Spring Boot application. So I created 2.4.5 folder because we are using 2.4.5. Inside that, I already created config service under service history using 2.4.5. In the previous video, that particular project implemented, that particular config service service is implemented using 2.4.2. This example, right, this under 2.4.5, I using 2.4.5 version. Okay, I'll share this project part of this video. You can use it. There is no any additional technical step, the same step which I explained in the previous video for config service and service registry. Okay, let me create account service now. I already filled all the information: group, comp.id, garden, artifact, account service name, account service description, then package name. I'm using Java 11. Now I need to add the dependency. I'm using Spring Web REST web services, so I'm adding a web, Spring Web. And then I need to add DB, right? So for that JPA we need to add. I need to connect with the database, so I'm adding JPA, Spring Data JPA. Then I want to connect with config server. For that we need to add an artifact called config client. Then I want to register this account service inside a Eureka naming server. Okay, Eureka naming server. For that we need to add Eureka client, Eureka discovery client. Okay, we have added necessary artifact. Then we'll generate it. I want to generate here. Extract the zip file. Okay, now I want to import this in IntelliJ. Okay, file new project from existing source. Account service. Select pom.xml file, click OK. New window. It's loading. It's building, I think. Okay, it's loaded. I'm changing this file to just application. Refactor why it is coming. Oh, still it is doing something, so it's not allowing to rename. Yeah, it's done. Refactor rename. I'll go to check this just application. This is not required, but I want to keep it as an application. Okay, next step is we need to configure the database. So if you want to configure database, what you have to do, we need to create an application or properties or application YAML file where we need to add the database configuration, right? So in order to configure the database or whatever configuration, if you want to add a part of Spring Boot application, we need to create an application or properties file or application.yaml file where we need to add all the configuration. Okay, since we are using microservice environment, we don't have to create a configuration file part of account service project itself, part of microservice project itself. Okay, we have to keep all the configuration in centralized location. That centralized location is our Git repository. I already created one Git repository here. This is my Git repository. Configs is a my repository where I am maintaining all the configuration. Now we are focusing on account service, right? Here we can see three different account service configuration file: dev, QA, and YAML. We are going to use account-service.yaml file. This is a default configuration file. We are going to use that. Okay, I pulled this configuration in my local machine. This is the folder. Okay, this is a folder. This folder I opened in a IntelliJ. See, account service already I configured. Account, the port number is 9091. Application name is account-service. Then database configuration. I'm connecting with account-test-db. Username and password. Then driver information. So this particular configuration, don't consider about this. I will explain later why I commented about this. Okay, then this is my own custom property, billing.app. this is billing app account service. This is billing app default account service. I am saying default account service. Why? Because account service.yaml is a default configuration. That's the reason I'm saying it's a default account service. Here we can say account service. What is here? You can say dev account service. What I adding here? Okay, you can say QA account service. Okay, now we're going to use this configuration only now. Okay, after changing, it's very mandatory, it's important to commit these changes, then only it will reflect. Okay, we need to commit and push it. Commit it. Committed, then push it. If you don't commit, it will never reflect the changes. Okay, okay, this is my account service configuration. Okay, this is available in our Git repository. Let's see if the changes are coming or not. So whatever I changed, it's coming here. Okay, now this configuration we need to use in our account service. How do you connect this account service to Git repository? Through config server. For that, we need to connect this account service to our config server. For that, we have one configuration. What is that configuration? We need to create one property file called bootstrap properties. What is that file name? Bootstrap properties. Bootstrap.properties. Then let me copy that configuration from my previous version of account service. Bootstrap. Just just copying it. I am pasting it to in our account service. I am removing this. This is not required. Okay. Here I am saying my account service name is, my application name is account service. Then I want to connect one config server. What is that config server URL? This is our config server URL. This is our config server URL. Okay. Now I'll copy this URL. This is my config service, right? This already started, it's running. Let me open that. Now I want to access. Now I want to access this particular file. This particular file, right? So just say account service. Oh, sorry. Just say account service. Then default account service, then localhost 8888 is my config server port number. Then which property you want to access? Account service property I want to access. Then which type of property? Default property. When you enter it, it will open. Yeah, it's open, right? So through this URL, I'm able to access any configuration. Okay, so in the account service, I am saying my config service URL is this one. Whenever I start this application, what will happen? In the pom.xml, XML, you remember we added a config client, right? We added config client. Then apart from this artifact, we need to add one more artifact. Go to account service, the previous version of account service, open the pom.xml file. This is the artifact. One more artifact we need to add. So for config server, to enable config client, to enable this account service as a config client, we need to add these two property files. So through artifact, what will happen? Through this artifact, it will generate some library, some jar files. With the help of that jar file, this account service connect to this config server, connect to this config server to load the account service properties, to load the account service properties. How it's happening through that library? Through this configuration, through this configuration. Here I am saying in my application name account service, my config server URL is a localhost colon 88. At the time of starting the server, our account service, our Spring Boot application, look at this URL, look at this URL and use this URL and use this particular name. Like this it will use. Like this it will use. If you not mentioned any profile, for example, auto profile, I think we need to say profile.active, profile.active equal to dev or QA, I think QA we need to mention, right? If you say like this, it will call the QA configuration. If you say dev, it will call the dev configuration. If you not mention anything like this, what will happen? This particular URL called the default profile. Default profile. It will construct the URL using this URL and using this name and to call the default profile. It will connect to the default URL. Just to copy and paste it here. It will connect. So it's loading, right? So it's construct this at the time of starting the server. Through this library, it will generate this URL and connect to the config server. Connect to the config server. From the config server, it load the account service default property. Account service default property. That meaning whatever properties available here, whatever configuration available here, it will use us. Therefore, account service uses 9091 port number that will connect to account-test.db. Account-test.db. Okay, let's see if it's working or not. Now I'm going to restart the application. I'll load the pom.xml files because I added one more artifact, right? I added this bootstrap artifact, so I'm loading the pom.xml file. Yeah, it's done. Now I'm going to start the server. Right click, run. See, the port number is 9091. Port number is 9091 because in the Git repository my configuration file is a 9091, showing the same. That meaning our account service connecting to the config server, from the config server distributing our account service default property to account service. The default property what I am using, port number 9091. So it's showing the same 9091 in the console also. I got some error now. Let's see what is the error. What is that error? Data source. Yeah, the problem is I added the Spring Boot starter data JPA, but I need to add the MySQL driver artifact. I need to add the MySQL driver artifact that I have not added. Go to the previous version of my account service. Open that POM. Copy this dependency. I am copying this dependency. Just paste it there. Okay. Reload the pom.xml file. Okay, reloaded. Just start the application again. This time it should work. This time no error while connecting with the DB because we added the MySQL driver artifact. So we don't have any error. That meaning we deployed successfully. See, I want to see, I want to show one more thing here. There is a one more artifact I added here. Spring Cloud Starter Netflix Eureka client. That meaning I want to register this account service in my Eureka naming server. Okay, in order to do that, we need to add this particular dependency. I will explain later why we need to register inside Eureka naming server when we communicate with one microservice to another microservice. I will explain that time why we need to register all our microservice inside a Eureka naming server. Okay, now our intention is I want to register account service Eureka naming server. For that we need to add this particular artifact. This artifact added through this particular dependency, Eureka discovery client. Okay, if you say Eureka discovery client, it will add that artifact. I already added. That meaning this particular, once you added this artifact, automatically what will happen, through this library it will register account service inside a Eureka naming server if the server is already running. So this will our service already running. Whenever start this application through this dependency library, this dependency provides some library. That library check the Eureka naming service already available or not. If it is running already, it will go under request. Please register, like that will go on request. Eureka naming server take that request and register this account service part of Eureka naming server. For that log, you can see here. When I start the application, you can see that log. See here. com.netflix.eureka.discovery-client. discovery.discovery-client. There are some log producing. Finally, you can see that registering log also. So Eureka service registering application account service. Registering application account service with the Eureka with the status up. That meaning it is registered the account service inside the Eureka naming server. Status is up and running. Okay. Now let's check the Eureka naming server dashboard. What is the dashboard? It's a 87. What is the port number? I forgot. It's a 8761, right? 8761. Localhost 8761. You right. Just enter it. You can see here this dashboard showing two services up and running, two services registered inside a Eureka naming server. One is account service, another one is config service. Another one is config service. See the config service also, I'm using that particular Eureka client artifact, client dependency. So through this client dependency, our config server registered inside a Eureka naming server. Similarly, account service also registered inside Eureka naming server. Okay. Part of this video, this session, we have created account service. We have connected the account service to config server to load the configuration of account service. We have deployed, we have registered our account service inside a Eureka naming server. Okay. I'll close the session now. The next video, we'll going to create a small table. We'll create a one table. Through that table, we'll implement one business logic which will register new customer. That's it. It will register new customer through account service. Account service, my account microservice responsibility is it will register customer, it will fetch the customer, it will fetch all the customer, it will view the customer. Okay, this is the responsibility of account microservice. That part we'll going to implement next video. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.